Hi everybody, and welcome back to Tech Interceptor. Okay, today we'll discover a new motherboard. Maybe it will be the model of your next PC build. This is the new MSI MAG B760M Mortar WiFi. First of all, remember to subscribe to the channel, activate the notification bell to stay up to date on upcoming videos, and if you want to take a look at our Twitter and Instagram profiles. And let's get on now. The motherboard in question belongs of a new MSI Intel B760 lineup. Starting from the box, we find obviously the motherboard, together the user manual, only one SATA 3 6GB 2nd cable, two Wi-Fi antennas, one easy M2 clip, one M2 screw and standoff puck, and one useful cable sticker. Dimensionally, the new MSI B760 board has a micro ATX form factor and it's sized 9.6 x 9.6 inches or 24.4 x 24.4 cm. The PCB of the board is totally black, no lines, no aesthetic colorful pattern, no distraction, nothing at all. The only thing that leans on it are the components of a board, chips, connector, capacitor, MOSFET, and logically the heatsinks. The cooling solution is very solid, it is composed by 4 metal brushed elements. The two main heatsinks above the capacitor and the MOSFET on top and on left, one another on top of the B760 chipset, and lastly one that aims the dissipation of the M2. All these, who less, who more, are distinguished by square design with angle cut at 45 degrees. Contrary to the PCB, that is very clean, every cooling part are reached by a geometric shapes, above all oblique and a trapezoid in grey or black colouring, and in addition by words such as MAG MSI 01 and by the model name of board, Mortar. But now we go to the technical aspects. The VRM layout is composed by 12 plus 1 plus 1 digital power faces that guarantee the maximum efficiency and the power necessary. At the core of the new Intel boards there is the 1700 socket. This socket equipped 3 different boards, including the already mentioned B760, but also its sisters, the powerful Z790 and the entry-level H770. The Intel 1700 CPU socket supports the 13th generation Intel Core processor. Anyway, it's backward compatible with whatever previous 12th generation Intel processors, including the Intel Core i9, i7, i5, i3, Pentium, Celeron, everyone. However, if you are some dubbed about the compatibility of your CPU, consult the manufacturer support for greater security. The current generation including a massive number of processors, where we can mark the presence of the 3 CPU, the i5-13600K, i7-13700K and the i9-13900K CPU. Precisely, in terms of specification they are dissimilar from each other. The Core i5-13600K has 14 core, of which 6 performance core and 8 efficient core, 12 thread, 5.1 GHz of boost clock, 24 MB of cache, all with a TDP of 125 watts. The Core i7-13700K has 16 core, of which 8 performance core and 8 efficient core, 24 thread, 5.4 GHz of boost clock, 40 MB of cache and a TDP of 125 watts. While the flagship Core i9-13900K has 24 core, of which 8 performance core and 16 efficient core, 32 thread, 5.8 GHz of boost clock, 36 MB of cache and a TDP of 125 watts. The same goes for the price, with the Core i5-13600K sells at $330, the Core i7-13700K is around at $420, and the Core i9-13900K at $600. The motherboard is equipped with 4DDR5 DIMM dual channel memory architecture, the latest generation of memory technology for PC. Compared with the DDR4, despite of a higher price, the DDR5 architecture is designed to provide some improvements such as high performance, high speed, as well as an unamplified capacity and a better power efficiency. We can installing a minimum of 32GB for single DIMM memory module, up to a maximum capacity of 128GB for all 4 DIMM. Operating base frequencies for memory can range from 4800 MHz to the incredible frequency of over 7000 MHz in overclocking. Moving to the motherboard layout, internal connection, starting from the left, on top we have got a 8+8-pin ATX 12V power connector for our CPU, an ARGB Gen 2 LED connector and a CPU fan header. After going down on the right, there are a water pump cooling fan header, a 24-pin ATX main power socket connector, and a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C front panel header, and a USB 3.2 Gen 1 header, and two SATA 3 6GB to second port. In the bottom, instead, the ASRock B760 Mobo has a system fan header, a front panel connector, a trusted platform module header, another front panel connector, 2-hour SATA connector, 2 USB 2.0 header, a chassis intrusion connector, a clear CMOS jumper, another ARGB Gen 2 LED header, a Thunderbolt add-on card connector, 2 system fan header, RGB LED connector, and a tuning controller connector. Moreover, in the center of the board there is a lastly system fan header. Instead, on back, the I/O panel has 4 USB 2.0 Type-A port, 1 display port, 1 HDMI port, 1 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A port, 1 USB 3.2 Gen 2 for 2 Type-C port, 1 2.5 Gigabit per second LAN port, our 2 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A ports, 2 Wi-Fi antenna connector, and an optical SPDIF out port connector, and the in-band the audio jacks, including central subwoofer out input, rear speaker input, line in input, line out input underlined by a red finish, and a microphone input port. For have more storage, the new B760 motherboard boasts 4 SATA 3 6GB to second connector and a 2 M.2 slot. Both support storage devices type 2232, 2260 and 2280 PCI Express Gen 4 operating at a 4.4 mode. This means that these be able to running up to a 64GB to second. In terms of expansion slot, it has 3 PCI Express, 1 reinforced PCI 5.0 for 16 slot operating at a 4.16 mode, 1.5 PCI Express for 16 slot, but 4.0 not reinforced and running at a 4.4 mode, and finally 1 smaller PCI Express 3.0 for 1 slot. The audio compartment isn't excellent. This is powered by the Realtek ELC897 audio codec that allows to have 7.1 channel high definition audio. But now it is the time to talk about the price. Well, the MSI MAG B760M Mortar Wi-Fi motherboard is not cheap but never expensive. It is available at price of around $200 or 240 euros at the time of making this video. As always, I leave you the all links to buy it in the description below. Alright, that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video and it was helpful. As always, let me know what do you think in the comments below, then leave a like, share it with all your friends and don't forget to subscribe. Huge thanks for watching, see you again next time!